And then we can go and get started. You're good?
Okay. I have to turn on the recorder, but yeah.
Okay. Meeting is called to order. It's 6:03. Orders of the day, none. No matters of public record. Public comment. Folks here tonight, if you have public comment, please submit them on the yellow sheet of paper. There's no public comment.
I have a...
Excuse me, roll call. The roll call being voted, wouldn't it? Call to order and roll call. Thank you very much, gentlemen. District 1, Franklin Wynn. District 1, Gary Cunningham.
Here.
Dave Wilkins.
Here.
Perry Henry.
Here.
Pete Colson.
Here.
John Smanek.
Here.
Alan Hinman.
Here.
John Swatton. Juan Estrada. Mimi Hernandez.
Present.
Jim Carter.
Here.
Olivia Navarro.
Here.
Jonathan Fleming.
Present.
Nicole Andreas. Here. Michael Young.
Here.
Terry Martin.
Here.
Richard Giamama.
Here.
Nick Lebowski. Great, we have a quorum. Continuing to the consent calendar, approving the minutes for the meeting of December 10th.
So I have something to say if no one else does.
Okay.
So this is Commissioner Fleming, and this is a question for staff. Did you receive the emails that were sent by three residents that I was CC'd on?
I don't think so.
Okay.
No, I don't think so.
So they had public comments today where the meeting minutes were not exactly correct. And let me pull up the minutes and I'll explain what that was. So under public comment, the one by Melinda Anesqua, her last name is Amezqua, A-M-E-Z. And she wanted her entire statement for the public record.
A-M-E-Z, you need you to spell it fully.
Okay, she did send the email to NC staff, but let me pull it up. A-M-E-Z-C-U-A.
C-U-A, is that what you said?
Yeah.
Zebra.
Yeah, zebra. Also, there was an email from Bruce Sullivan and David Serrano to the same effect. They wanted their comments made in the public record.
If they did not give me a paper version, I cannot provide it as part of public record. It has to remain as public comment.
Okay, well, in the email that they sent, they said that they wanted it updated and they included their statement.
If it wasn't included in the meeting, I still cannot submit it as public record, unless it's submitted as public record for this meeting, but I didn't have it, so it could be public record for the next meeting.
Okay. So even though they said submit for the public record at the end of their statement and submitted the
They didn't give version. Me the paper. I actually was waiting for the handouts. Nobody gave them to me, so
okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'll let you respond to them. Thank you.
Sure.
Great. Any other questions or comments about the minutes? Any motion?
I move that we accept the minutes as presented.
Second.
Great motion from Martin and second from Carter. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
And motion carries.
I'm sorry, can we just check for recusals since we have new commissioners?
For what?
Recusals on the minutes.
Yes. Okay, let me do a proper formal vote. All right. Motion, all in favor? Aye. I'll read the names. Thank you. Navarro, Carter, Henry, Hernandez, Idreas. Are you agreed? Okay. Fleming. Cunningham, recusal is Young, Martin, Giamama, Colstead, Wilkins, Semantic. Recusal is Alan Hinman. Thank you, Sabrina, for that.
Thank you.
Great. So my comments are brief as they have been. Happy New Year to everyone. This is going to be a very exciting year for the Commission. We have done a great job over the past couple of years taking action, and we're starting to build and grow and snowball into producing quite a bit of plan work for the city. Pete Colson will speak tonight about that, Commissioner Cunningham will speak tonight about that, and Jonathan, Commissioner Fleming will review the status of our progress there. We have two new commissioners here tonight, who I'd like to offer the chance to introduce themselves. And a third, Frank Franklin Lynn, who has not arrived, and we'll find out about him. Commissioner Hinman, would you like to introduce yourself and say what brings you here and a little bit about yourself, please?
My name is Alan Hinman. I'm from District 4. I've lived in San Jose now. My name is Alan Hinman. I'm from District 4. I've lived here in San Jose off and on for about 20 years. I've lived in my present location in District 4 for about 11, almost 12 years. I grew up on the peninsula. I lived in San Francisco many years. I'm an electrical mechanical engineer. I started with IBM right out of college. Then I went, I was actually sold to Eastman Kodak Company, moved to Rochester and froze to death, and then came back home. Then I was sold to Canon Corporation, which is here on North First Street. That was my office. I started to have some ill health and have had two spinal surgeries in the last 18 months. I'm now almost back to what I think is 100% for my age, and hopefully that will continue. I have one daughter, age 20. I have a girlfriend who has MS. I just drove 7,000 miles to get her from here back to the Philadelphia area and back home. She can't fly, so I had to drive her there because her sister is very ill and wanted to make one last visit before she passed. And that brings me to today. I'm really excited to be with this commission. I think we'll all have a lot of fun together.
Great. If I may ask, there are a lot of places you could be on a Wednesday night at 6:10. What has you have yourself in this seat tonight?
Well, I got involved with my community, which is a mobile home community, because we have, I would say, predominantly older people there, and the owner of our park was abusing quite a few of them, so I started advocating for them. I went through the rental rights hearing process where I was the proxy for many of them, and we did pretty good. I started to get involved with the rental rights people upstairs. Lon Deep, I worked with him when he was trying to become elected, before he was elected, and that started to kind of spur me on to, once Donald Trump became president, I said, why am I asking other people to do something that I'm not willing to get involved with? And so I decided to get involved, and that brings me here tonight.
Great. Well, thank you. Welcome.
Thank you.
In a moment, Franklin Lynn joined us. In a moment, just don't want to surprise you or spring it on you. We'll ask you to introduce yourself and say what brings you here. And first, we're going to introduce Michael Young. Michael, what brings you here? Welcome.
Hi, good evening. I'm really honored and excited to be part of the Neighborhoods Commission. I've lived in Cambrian Park with my wife in District 9 since 1985, and we have three children that attended local schools there. I'm retired out of a career in local government, and really interested in the city, and I'm excited about the city of San Jose and what we're doing here, and want to have a chance to speak to people out in District 9 and bring their concerns back to this commission, as well as bringing the energy and the ideas from this commission out to the residents. And I'm really happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And welcome, Franklin Lynn, if you would say a few words and introduce yourself.
Yeah. Hi, everyone. Apologies for the late arrival. I underestimated my traffic from Premium Valley Fair to here. It was going 3 miles, but quite longer than I expected. But yeah, I'm happy and excited to join the Neighborhoods Commission. I'm very grateful to all of you that interviewed me. I recently moved back from Austin, Texas, and I'm recently married too, back in November. So once I moved back, I saw a lot of the changes that had happened in my district, and I wanted to have a voice in the community after I moved back. And now that I'm starting a family, I felt that would be a great opportunity to make some change in the community. And so that's why I decided to pursue this opportunity and provide some sort of civic duty and help out where I could. So thank you, everyone, for allowing me to be here today. Yeah.
Thank you. And I know this may sound a little funny, but do people want to rearrange your seats so a new commissioner can sit next to a more experienced commissioner? Would that be of value to people? You're fine. I know you've grown up.
I'm not so sure who the experienced people are versus...
It's everyone else in the room.
I think that's a good idea.
Good logic.
So, Jim's going to switch with our friend from the council member's office. So you can stay where you are, Franklin.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Great. And if you... Right. Thank you. Oh, other... One more down. Yeah. You sit between them.
Perfect. But can you move over there to where Jim was?
You're switching with Jim.
There we go.
You're surrounded by a wealth of knowledge, Michael. You're in good hands. Okay.